There are a lot of ways to concealed carry, and off-body is not always the best option, but sometimes it's really your only option. And today, I think we're gonna do a deep dive on great concealed carry options for off-body carry.
I think it's really important for someone to know, based on their pistol selection, what works for them and also what activity they're doing.
I love this fanny pack just because I run with it every single day. I go long distance runs. I know it's very sturdy for my firearm. I have this nice soft holster that protects the trigger and carries my firearm. It also has the retention strap. I'm carrying this the Ruger LCR 38 Special. And so I'm just gonna share with you guys. It's a little snug, but a little snug is great. And so
Yeah, you can see that your soft case covers the trigger and trigger guard, keeping everything secure. And you can tighten that retention strap to kind of fit the firearm that you choose.
And the other thing I noticed is, because of the Velcro, this is actually ambidextrous, so that you can turn it around, flip it around if you're left-handed. So I think that makes it really nice with the double zippers. You can place the zippers to where you can access your firearm quickly by only pulling one down.
And the nice thing about that is there's additional pockets on there, so your firearm is in its own separate compartment away from anything else you might have, like keys
or
gear.
Absolutely.
A couple things to consider, though, with the fanny pack is how it's going to fit on your body. So can you get the actual fanny pack snug enough around your hips and waist to where it feels secure? Your firearm's not loose and bouncing around. So there are fanny packs out there that are specifically designed for firearm carry. So they have in place retention straps inside the fanny packs that will hold your pistol secure. There are a lot of fanny packs that are not designed for concealed carry. So there are some considerations that you want to make before you just grab your fanny pack, throw your gun in it, and go jogging.
Absolutely. Especially, you know, protecting your trigger is something that's huge.
Yeah.
Off-body carry is definitely a secondary for me, especially having a young child in my home. I think it's really important that I carry on my body, but there's times where I can't, whether it's what I'm wearing or a situation where I'm very active with Olivia. My go-to is our Tomboy purse, and the reason that I love this purse is the size, number one. I'm a small person, and so I like to have a smaller purse, and also I'm able to carry a couple different sizes of firearms in here. One of the things that I like is that you have an individual holster that can be adjusted to fit several different firearms. Having an ambidextrous purse is really important as well, because we do have left and right-handed shooters, and being able to know that you have a good strap and that you can carry crossbody. I like to adjust my strap, because I am shorter, to where it's at a good height for me to access my firearm with the pocket on the outside. And I also like to adjust the zippers to where I only have to use one zipper by pulling down and reaching in. And at that point, I can either shoot from my purse or I can access it quickly and pull it out.
So one thing that is nice about this purse is you have the choice of carrying either crossbody or just kind of over the shoulder. And with this purse, and with a lot of concealed carry purses that are designed for concealed carry, they are designed for that ambidextrous feature. So if you have this purse over your right shoulder, how are you gonna access your firearm? You're gonna flip and turn. Always, every time, it's a motion that goes with that. So when you just throw your purse over your shoulder, when you're carrying, you have to consider every time strategically, where is my purse out of my body? Where is my muzzle pointed on my firearm? Because you are never going to want to just pick up your purse, throw it over the wrong shoulder, because you need to always think of your purse as a defensive mechanism. Jen, you mentioned having to possibly shoot through these purses, and they are designed where that can be a possibility. But if you look at the construction of them, by the time your firearm is inside this pocket, you really have to almost get it all the way out. You're almost at a half draw cycle to even be able to reach the trigger and get it out of that soft holster. There is some limitations when it comes to shooting through a purse. It's not as easy as everybody thinks, like, oh, I'll just grab my firearm and shoot through my purse. It's really not that simple. So with a lot of these, it's much more safe as far as being able to aim your firearm and being able to not have that barrier of having to shoot through. There are some malfunctions that can happen if you try to shoot through your purse during a defensive situation. Right. For example, if you're running a semi-automatic pistol, you may encounter, you know, a fabric or maybe something will jam the slide and keep operation from happening, which makes a revolver sometimes maybe a better choice.
That's what I was gonna say, that I do in most situations, I will carry my LCR when I'm in a purse carry situation, because if I did have to shoot through the purse, it's going to perform. We don't have to worry about those types of malfunctions. And I think that it's very important for you to have different firearms because when we conceal carry, we make a choice. Yeah. We choose to defend ourselves. And at that point, we have to dress, we have to have the right equipment, and know that we have the right firearm for whatever holster or purse that or fanny pack that we're using.
And it goes beyond that. It even goes to ammunition.
Absolutely.
So making sure a lot of defensive ammunition is a hollow point ammunition. So making sure you have something like Hornady Critical Defense, which has the patented flex tip fill, that prevents any clogging, which ensures bullet performance in a defensive situation. So bullet selection, the type of firearm you choose, how you're carrying, it all is so important. And then, you know, your purse becomes an extension of your body.
Absolutely.
You can't set your purse down with your firearm in it and walk away at a, from your table, from the grocery store. There's a lot of women at events that will want to drape their purse over the back of their chair. Absolutely not acceptable. Your purse, if your firearm is in there, has to remain on your body. Or in control, in your control at all times.
Which is what makes a crossbody strap. I mean, that is
That's what makes it
so critical to have. Because for me, you know, your purse is here, it could slip, you want to lay it down, you want to set it down, and you can't. It's just not an option in that case. Another thing that's really important is, if you have the option, is to have something that's lockable. So in this case, not that I would ever leave my firearm, but there may be a situation where I need to lock it up, and I can here with the keys on the purse.
And so, for example, a situation you might need to lock a firearm and want a purse that has locking zippers, going over state boundary lines. You encountered that on the way here to Oregon.
On my way, once we were getting ready to cross the border, we pulled over. I pulled my magazines out, kept them in the front of my purse, and then I had to lock up and secure my firearm.
Because you don't have a concealed carry card in the state. So these purses are also designed to help you be able to secure, store, and transport firearms as well.
Absolutely. It's really important.
The Adventure Crossbody is a vertical drop of the firearm into the purse. So instead of it being horizontal in the purse, like this one is, the Adventure Crossbody is a vertical drop. So your pistol's actually gonna drop barrel down into this purse.
And what's critically important for something that is a vertical drop, when you're trying to access your firearm, that you need to clear the purse first. So you don't have an accident or you don't have something that is in your way. Clearing it, and in most situations, because self-defense situations happen so quickly.
3 seconds or
less. 3 seconds
usually.
Or less. Yeah. And you are going to have to pull and typically shoot from the hip. And it's a really good idea in my case, because I don't off-body carry very often, if I choose to do it that day, I will clear my firearm and place my firearm in, and I will actually do a couple dry fires. So I'm practicing and I'm fresh that day, and I know exactly anything that I'm gonna run into or any issues with that off-body carry holster of choice. Yeah.
So with the Adventure Crossbody, you can carry this purse a couple of ways. You can do the granny style here with your arms, which is fine. It's totally fine. Or you can also do single shoulder, or you can do crossbody. The nice thing about this purse is you have multiple carrying options. It is a vertical drop. However, inside this purse, and you'll see it has its own designated pocket for your firearm to go in. One thing you always, always want to make sure with any type of purse carry is that your firearm is in its own pocket. So you don't have a pen or any strange object that can somehow get inside that trigger guard and have your firearm have a negligent discharge, which would be detrimental in any situation. So we always want to protect ourselves. In this purse, it also has a Velcro piece that your soft holster adheres to the purse, keeping it very secure. One thing that is nice with a vertical drop, in my opinion, is I can have my purse crossbody, and I can actually have my hand sitting inside the purse, and I can walk in a scary parking lot with my hand on my firearm. And I think anytime you're carrying with a purse, I think it's of the utmost importance that you practice situational awareness. If you have that creepy crawly feeling and you don't feel good about something, get your hand on your gun. It's in your purse. You're not flashing anybody. Mm-hmm. You're not exposing your firearm. You're not doing anything illegal, but be prepared. Be prepared to pull it out of that holster if you have that sense of doom. I mean, mm-hmm. that's what being aware is what's going to keep us alive.
Yeah. A lot of people in today's world, they are so focused on their devices, mm-hmm. walking with their head down. Situational awareness is something that most people don't even take into account. Mm-hmm. And the other thing is visualization also. Being able to visualize your scenario. For mm-hmm. me, for example, if I am in a restaurant, mm-hmm. I make sure and position myself properly. I know where all my exits are.
Yes.
I'm almost always traveling with my 2-year-old daughter. So I also make sure, what would I do in this situation mm-hmm. with her? And how would I protect myself and my family in that situation? So it's really important to not only practice situational awareness, but also to visualize what you would do in that situation, because your body is going to remember that most mm-hmm. recent thought, that most recent memory.
Mm-hmm. There are ways that we can concealed carry with a purse that's not specifically designed for it, but there are the same type of considerations we need to make. For example, this is one of my favorite fashion Western bags.
That is really cute.
I can over the shoulder carry it. It does not have the easy reach like the Tomboy where I can mm-hmm. strategize my zipper openings. Right. And it doesn't allow me to crossbody carry. It does allow me to the over shoulder carry, which I feel good about, but it's better than nothing. This has a zippered pocket in the back that I can use specifically for my firearm. So I can take a soft holster, and if you want really inexpensive, you can go to any fabric store and you can get a piece of Velcro adhesive. Mm-hmm. You can put Velcro on here and then actually put Velcro in your purse. Mm. And that will contain where the soft holster is placed in the bag. Otherwise, this pocket's small enough, it's very secure. Mm-hmm. I feel very good with my firearm being in here. And it is in its own pocket, and it's kind of hidden. Although it's not that accessible with me right-handed. So if I were to carry this purse, I would probably want to try to carry it on the left side of my body, and I would keep this zipper open. Mm-hmm. And then if I felt like I needed to be in a defensive situation, I could quickly reach in and grab my firearm. Mm. Right. Now it will be in the soft holster, so having the Velcro in here mm-hmm. keeps the holster in place mm-hmm. so that I can pull only my firearm out mm-hmm. if I need to reach it.
And one of the things that I think is really important, no matter what choice you make, is that you practice that. Yes. You practice it dry, fire at home, you know, and you're comfortable and confident in the mm-hmm. way that you're going to carry. Mm-hmm. Because that's what matters. If we don't have a self-defense tool, we can't protect ourselves. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So whatever works for each individual person, whether it's on-body carry, off-body carry, as long as you're comfortable and confident in it, I think that's the best choice.
I think the most important thing with all of these mm-hmm. off-body carry options is safety. Mm-hmm. Keeping our firearm in a pocket that is of its own pocket, there's nothing else inside it, making sure we have the firearm either in a trigger guard or a mm-hmm. soft case, and then being situationally aware. Where is the firearm placed in that purse? How am I going to access it? We are all safe, responsible gun owners, and regardless of how we choose to carry, mm-hmm. we're all responsible for our firearms. So making sure that we always have firearm safety, keeping our muzzles pointed in a safe direction, mm-hmm. keeping our finger off the trigger, mm-hmm. keeping our trigger guards safe and protected. These are our responsibilities. Absolutely. Having our bags on us all the mm-hmm. time if we are off-body carrying, it's our responsibility, mm-hmm. and we don't take that lightly, mm-hmm. which is why we encourage all of you, find as many resources as you can for education and find the right way to carry that is going to suit your lifestyle, because everybody is so different.
And Kristy, it's really important for each and every person to find a certified instructor. Work with someone. If you don't know, if you are a new gun owner, get out there. Make the selection that works best for you, mm-hmm. become proficient, and carry. That's the most important part.
That's right.
If you're not carrying, you can't protect yourself.